Hello, and welcome to Connecting You to You Radio, where we tune in to receive the messages of health and well-being that are being broadcast from the soul. I'm your host, Lisa Warner, author of The Simplicity of Self-Healing. I show you how to heal your body naturally by combining your body's innate intelligence with the wisdom of your own soul, so that you can break through the mental programming of limiting beliefs that cause disease and make healing your body and changing your life simple. Hello and welcome. Welcome to another Lunch with Lisa. I'm Lisa Warner. I am the author of The Simplicity of Self-Healing. We are in unprecedented times on this planet. We are moving from the age of darkness into the age of light. So today is, this video is premiering on the 4-4 portal, April 4th, 2024. And this is numerologically, today is a very significant day, as is the 4-8 solar eclipse that's coming up. So this eclipse is a significant astrological event. All of these things that are happening right now on the planet are very significant. And it's very easy to get caught in the chaos, the confusion, the trauma and drama that are playing out for our viewing pleasure. And it's very easy to go into fear. It's very easy to go into doomsday scenarios. It's very easy to get caught up in, you know, what's happening on the surface level. But this is what actually causes disease in our body, the dis-ease in our minds, the fear, the doubt, the worry, the confusion. These all are electrical charges that run through our bodies. We are beings of electromagnetics. We are beings of light and love. And when that light and love gets focused and energized, it collapses into matter, into physicalness. So anybody can tell you, any scientist will tell you that our bodies are not physical. They're literally made of light. And the original design is we're made from the love of God, Source, Creator. When I was a very little girl, I had the experience of being in that beautiful space of infinite unconditional love and light. It was a visceral, palpable, real experience. And it was very clear to me that all that is comes from this space. Well, at that time, that's what I thought. When I realized all that is organic and divine comes from that space. On this planet, there's a lot of stuff that's not organic and it's not divine. And it doesn't come from this space of love. But what has happened on this planet over thousands upon thousands of years is that we have been living in the age of darkness, where darkness has been in command. Darkness, we can look at it as evil, meaning E-V-I-L, which is the opposite of L-I-V-E. God, Source, Creator, creates life, everlasting life, ever growing, ever expanding, ever joyful, ever jubilant, beautiful, thriving life. But there is also a source of anti-life, which sucks the living life force energy out of us, that has been in charge for a very long time on this planet. And this is why we've never had peace. We've never had unconditional love. We've never had real, true thriving in our lifetimes or any other lifetime that we can remember since the creation of the planet. But there have been times, the original creation of this planet, we were created from love in a divine design. And this is one ecosystem where all of the plants, all of the animals, all of the living beings live together in one thriving ecosystem. We can see evidence of that thriving ecosystem even today. When you go out into a bog, into the desert, into the forest, anywhere that man hasn't already screwed it all up, where nature is just nature, we see a thriving, balanced ecosystem. But where mankind has interfered, we see pollution, we see devastation, we see destruction, we see strip mining, we see all kinds of disrespect to our beautiful Mother Earth. That disrespect has been in charge of this planet for a very long time. But now is the time of the Great Awakening. This is the time of the great shift from the darkness back into the light. So what we are watching now is we are watching the systematic dismantling of the structures that were created by the dark forces. All of the structures that were designed to harness our living life force energy and keep us as humanity living in states of war, poverty, disease, fear, control and manipulation. All of those old structures that were created from the anti-life agenda have to be dismantled so that we can set ourselves free. We are here moving the earth back up into its divine, pristine state of love and light. So this particular time on the planet, there are alignments of astrological significance that are happening. And if we stay focused on the significance and the intention of what's actually happening here is that we are moving back into light. We are literally raising the earth back up in frequency, so we can move back up into the bandwidths of light and love, out of these dark anti-life bandwidths that we've been in, called, often referred to as the third dimension or the matrix. So in the matrix, disease and all of these things have been just normal. We have been taught to expect these things. So what we expect, we get. We manifest. Why? Because we are creators. We are grand beings of light. We are souls, infinite and eternal, unlimited in our capacity to create, who have come and incarnated into physical form. We are still the soul. We are not these physical forms. We are still grand creator beings. But because of the false matrix, because of these artificial constructs that have been these anti-life constructs, humanity is in a state of collective amnesia. We believe that we're mere mortals. We're not mere anything. We are grand beings of light. when I was 2 years old. I don't know why it was, but when I was in the realm of light and unconditional love from which all life emanates, originates, I could look at the earth and I could see the amnesia. I could see that humanity was walking around without any awareness of who they truly are. I could see humans feeling small, feeling like victims, feeling empty, feeling unfulfilled. Just time to make the donuts, time to go to work, time to get a paycheck, and just living every day in this is what I gotta do, this isn't what we have to do at all. So this time on this planet, during this specific period of time, we as humanity have a very big opportunity to create better for ourselves and this planet. And it's up to us to do this. It is up to us to focus our intention, okay? As light and love, how we get into these physical forms that are literally made of light, they're not density, they're not solid like we believe they are, like it feels that they are. Any scientist will tell you, put any part of you that is solid underneath an electron microscope and you will see that there are just little particles, little quarks of light that are either, sometimes they're wavelengths and sometimes they collapse into particle. So in order to collapse the wavelength of light into a particle, there has to be focus. The light collapses when it is focused upon. So when we are shown pictures of death and destruction and disaster and disease, that's what we focus on. That's where our attention is going. And the more people that focus on that, the more we generate that. And the anti-life forces force these images on us all day, every day in news, media, movies, TV, newspapers. Look at this, look at this, latest disaster on the front page everywhere. Look, look, look. This could be terrible. This is going to have long-lasting impacts. Look at it in the future, creating devastation and just, okay? No. We have to stop. In order to turn this ship around and start creating heaven on earth, we have to stop participating. We have to stop flowing our energy in the direction of destruction, in the direction of worst case scenario. Right now, all of creation, the stars in the heavens are literally aligning to send us energy and frequency that will raise our consciousness. It will raise our frequencies. But it will not force it upon us. It will not just automatically raise our consciousness and all of a sudden it's like, oh, wow, geez, what just happened? Everything is phenomenal. It's not what's going to happen. If people are still focused on, oh my God, this is bad, okay, those higher light energies are not going to penetrate that. It takes open, receptive consciousness. It takes awareness and intention to receive these downloads, to receive the light that is being sent. It's like, you know, when you have man overboard on a ship and you got the little circular thing, throw it over the, you know, the thrown over the life vest or the boot, whatever those things are called. You know, you throw them a lifeline, right? The universe is literally throwing us a lifeline right now. And there are those of us who will gladly grab onto that lifeline and allow ourselves to be lifted up. And there are some who are not even going to notice this. They're going to just going to continue straight down that path of death and destruction. So this is a time of healing, both personal healing and planetary healing. Not only planetary, but universal. What has been happening on Earth has had an impact on all of the rest of the universe, because Earth is a nexus planet. Earth is a portal. Earth is a gateway between the upper and lower realms. And what happens on Earth affects everyone else in our galactic neighborhood. So all of the galactic neighborhood that's been keeping an eye on us for a long time, they're all rooting for us. Because when we set ourselves free, it also sets them free. Because they have been living under this veil of darkness for a long time as well. It has been affecting their growth. So now is a very good time to start focusing on what it is that we want to create, not only for ourselves, for our own personal futures, but also the future of Earth and humanity. How would we like to see life on Earth happening? Would you like to see peace on Earth? Would you like to see all beings thriving? The trees thriving, the plants thriving, the animals thriving, the living waters thrive, living once again. The living waters that have been polluted beyond recognition, that have been turned into dead water. Would you like to see its life restored? Would you like to see our atmosphere and our weather restored to balance and clarity? Would you like to see yourself restored to balance and clarity? Thriving, healthy body, healthy mind, healthy energy flow. If you would like this, please focus on this. Please don't let yourself get distracted by the headlines, by the doomsday scenarios, because there will be many of those, because the dark is trying to hold on. Its grip is slowly deteriorating, and the dark is starting to fall off the cliff. So it's doing everything it can to maintain power, to maintain itself in the spotlight, so that we keep focusing on the dark. But we're in the age of light. We have a choice. We can continue to focus on the dark, the doom, and the gloom. Or we can actually amplify the light. We can take the light that is being sent to us from Source and from all of our galactic neighbors. All of this light and love is being sent to us on a daily basis. The Earth is being bathed in light and love? Are you willing to receive it? Are you willing to tune in to the subtle energy realms around you? Are you willing to tune in to your own aura, your own personal energy field, and allow your own personal energy field to be uplifted and upgraded? Are you willing to open to receive the light and the love that is being sent? We are here to raise planet Earth. We are here to heal not only ourselves, but this beautiful planet and all of humanity. We are here to heal society. We are here to heal all of the wrongs that have been done, all of the wounds of the past are now here to be healed, not repeated. So in these coming days, pay attention to the love and the light that are being sent. They're being sent in the subtle energy realms. They're not gonna be broadcast on TV. They're not gonna show it to you. It's not gonna show up in an envelope in your mailbox. It's not gonna show up, you know, something that drops out of the sky and onto your head in a physical form. It is dropping out of the sky onto your head right now. But you have to tune in. You have to actually look for it. You have to tune your attention and your focus into this light. Because when you tune in and focus on the light and the love that are being sent, we can collapse those into our physical reality. This is how physical stuff comes into form. Everything is non-physical until it is concentrated, focused and concentrated into enough density that it turns into physical form, into physical circumstances. This is how we create. In order to create, we have to have an idea, we have to focus on it, and then we have to hold our focus steady long enough for the universe to rearrange its molecules to give it to us in physical form. So now is the time to focus on peace, on love, on prosperity, on the grand divine design of the universe. And bring the divine back to life. I hope this was helpful. If so, let me know. If so, subscribe to my channel. If so, please share it. If you'd like more information about self-healing, check out my book, The Simplicity of Self-Healing. If you'd like to know more about me and what it is that I have to offer, please go to connectingyoutoyou.com. You can find out more. I have a lot that is just about to be unveiled. I have lots of new courses, lots of new things that are coming up, and you want to be first to know. So when you go to my website, sign up for my newsletter, so you can be in the know of all the things that are just about to be released. So I've got lots of really cool stuff for this year for you guys. So hopefully this was helpful. If so, please let me know. Until next week, create for yourselves a beautiful, prosperous, kind, loving, peaceful week, because you can. Bye for now.
Thanks for listening to this episode of Connecting You to You Radio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, please subscribe and share it with your friends. Are you ready to discover more about how simple healing your body can actually be when you do it from the higher wisdom of your soul? To learn more about what I do and how you can work with me, visit connectingyoutoyou.com and get on my mailing list to be the first to know about my latest offerings. If you'd like to interact with me on Facebook, please join my group, Soul Sourced Healing. Check the show notes below for these links and more. I hope to see you again next time on Connecting You to You Radio.